Hi, my name is Cambria, your host of the AdVocation Nation podcast, a podcast dedicated to highlighting different advocacy and stories from many different walks of life. Episodes come out every Wednesday, and you can subscribe and follow on YouTube, SoundCloud, Spotify to stay tuned for more updates. We're so glad to have you here listening. Today, I'm joined by Mary Dwight with the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation.
As Senior Vice President of Policy and Advocacy, Mary directs the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation's public policy agenda and efforts to support people living with CF. She is a catalyst for accelerating efforts to remove barriers to clinical drug development and also leads the strategic development of the foundation's efforts to enable and expand access to CF care. She has a strong history in policy and legislation, and I more personally got to know her during a policy and advocacy internship I did with the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation a few summers ago to support people like my younger brother living with cystic fibrosis. I'm so honored to have Mary here on the show and to talk more about her advocacy journey. Welcome, Mary.
Thanks, Cambria. Thanks for inviting me. I'm really honored to be here.
Yeah, it's so good to talk to you. So to start us off, would you just tell us a little bit more about your background and how you eventually ended up getting involved in policy and advocacy?
Sure. It kind of goes way back to my family, really, with two parts to know about that. One, my father's a doctor. And so some of my very earliest memories are going to the hospital with him and helping him, you know, such that a 4 or 5 year old can help take care of patients and getting to know his patients. And that was such a really critical thing for my father throughout his career as a physician, was his personal connection with the people he helped take care of. So I always knew healthcare was something interesting and personal and something that you could really have an impact on people's lives through. But I initially thought I was going to be a doctor and pretty quickly realized that, that was not going to be my cup of tea. But somehow healthcare kind of kept brewing back there as an interest area. And the other thing from my family is I have a hyper-political family. On both sides of the aisle, I had grandparents and aunts and uncles and my stepmother and many folks who were very, very engaged in the political process and really felt passionately about it as a place to make a change and make an impact. And like I said, that spanned the spectrum of politics, Republicans and Democrats. So I always was aware of political issues and political discussions, and importantly, aware that the policy sphere was a place where you really could impact positive change. And so those two things sort of landed me in college to try to figure out what was the right fit for me and what a career might look like in policy. What might that look like and what did I enjoy? So I dabbled in a lot of different things in college and internships, both in school and in summers, and kind of stumbled into working on Capitol Hill in Washington, D.C. for a member of Congress from my home state of Colorado, and really just fell in love with being able to work on healthcare issues at a federal level, which really was the start of my career and ultimately took me on a path to the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation.
Yeah, that is so great. And I really like what you had to say about policy being able to impact change. I feel like a lot of times people can look at policy and see it as this big, like scary thing of like, okay, what does this all mean? And how does it actually help folks? But when you're pushing policies and you're actively listening to the communities that you're in, like you said, you understood that healthcare was a personal thing and there are many different aspects to it and needs with it. It definitely becomes more tangible and easier and more accessible to folks who want to get more involved in the policy realm. It's not this big, huge, scary thing. I think anyone can kind of get involved in that. So that's really great.
Yeah, I would say ultimately, for me, a healthcare policy career has been about helping people. And there are so many ways you can do that. But I think healthcare policy is a nice sweet spot of really being able to see tangible impact in people's lives.
For sure. And it's so nice when you see those policies pass and you're like, yay, finally, like what I've been advocating for went through and what many other folks have been advocating for. I think that's a really cool part of it is that you're working within a community. It's not just one singular thing, but it's a lot of people and policies and issues just coming together. And so this kind of leads me into my next question of what does advocacy look like for you at the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation? I guess just kind of What is your day-to-day role and how does that play a role into advocacy and policy?
Well, no day is the same, which is one reason I love my job. It's never boring. So if I was thinking at a high level of what does advocacy look like at the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation, to me, there are two pieces of that. One, how do we advance the mission of the organization, which is to find a cure for cystic fibrosis? And until we do, help people with cystic fibrosis live rich, meaningful lives and all the different components that go into what does that look like. And then the second part is that we do that by really ensuring that the CF community has a platform to share their stories and the things that they need to be able to have that mission, that end game that we want someday. So whether that means something around research or drug discovery, being able to say this is a need. For example, right now we're working a lot on antibiotics development and making sure that we can influence and change the marketplace for the development of antibiotics, which is so important for people with cystic fibrosis. Or if it means that their healthcare is more affordable and they're able to get the care that they need at their specialized care center. I think, Cambria, you know well, we do so much work in making sure that healthcare insurance works for people with cystic fibrosis, that it's available for anyone who needs it. So that's sort of how it translates into day-to-day. But ultimately, the two questions are, does this get us where people with CF need to go? And are we really making sure that the voices of the CF community are amplified in that discussion?
Yeah, that's really great. And I think just thinking about the fact that people with CF aren't the only people going through these healthcare issues either. So kind of the advocacy of the cystic fibrosis community and foundation doesn't necessarily just stop with CF patients, but so many people have insurance issues and need medicines to go through quicker. And there are just so many different ways that healthcare advocacy for one community impacts others. So I think that's really amazing and just kind of wonderful to see that kind of ripple effect.
Yeah, I'm so glad you brought that up because I think that's one of my favorite things about working for the CF Foundation. It's an amazing community. You know, as we know, it's an amazing story, right? What we've been able to accomplish as a community and the changes that we've seen in cystic fibrosis just in the 15 years I've worked with this community are nothing short of remarkable and exciting. And at the same time, we know we're not done and we know we still have so much work to do. But what I love about it is I firmly believe that cystic fibrosis is the best story in medicine and that we really can serve as a model for healthcare across the country, across the board, and really sometimes across the world. And that the needs of the CF community really reflect the needs of healthcare overall. When something works in CF, we want to share that story. We want to make sure that people hear about our successes and that they're able to translate that into other diseases so that it helps more people. And importantly, when something isn't working and is broken, we need to shout that from the rooftops because we have such a remarkable CF system and community, particularly when I think about how we deliver care for people with CF in these specialized care centers across the country. If it doesn't work there, then it's really not going to work for other people with chronic illness or even just an acute problem. And so we need to share that story too. What I love is I really do believe that the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation and the community can be a model of what healthcare should look like for everyone. And to me, that makes the job a lot of fun to try to problem solve. Certainly for CF first and foremost, but also knowing that if we problem solve in CF, that it's a model many others can replicate.
Yeah, that's so great. And I think also just thinking about advocacy and kind of what that means. And part of it is just being able to share your story and use your voice and say, hey, this thing is going on in my life. And I'd like to share that and help folks, not just even like me or people I love or know, but people all around the country or in your area, whatever it may be you're advocating for. So I really just like how you talk about that real amplification of voice and story and how that really plays a role in getting healthcare policies through and also just really making a difference, not only in one community, but in others as well. And so I guess this kind of makes me wonder a little bit about what are some healthcare policies that we could be keeping an eye on right now, at least with like COVID or some things that you've been working on recently. What's kind of just like a quick overview on some things that people could be a little bit more aware of in the healthcare policy field?
There are two things I would flag right now that we're particularly watching. There are always many, many things, but the two that I'd love to focus folks on is one, if we're thinking about the need for new therapies for cystic fibrosis, I mentioned this a little bit earlier, how do we help improve antibiotics development? And as you know, Cambria, there's so many different ways the CF Foundation is trying to bring new therapies to people with CF right now, but in the policy space, antibiotics is a particular focus for us. And that's because in part, we can't do it alone. And we know that people with CF are gonna need new antibiotics. And we know that the antibiotics market isn't really working well. There's not a lot of incentive for companies to come and develop a new antibiotic because they're not rewarded for it. What we really want for a new antibiotic, honestly, sometimes is for it to sit on the shelf and only be used when you absolutely have to use it and nothing else works. And that's not really a money-making scheme, right? If you're going to make a product that you want to just sit there and not be used. So how do we incentivize development of new antibiotics in a different way? And this is something where I'm super proud of the CF community and the CF Foundation, because we're really the leading patient voice at the table for asking for a new way to develop antibiotics and a new way to think about rewarding or paying for these novel new drugs. Because we have patients, people with CF, who have had bad bugs that didn't have an antibiotic that worked for them. And we're a unique place where we share our story about the need for this. So it's something that we're working with a whole lot of people across a spectrum of everything from drug developers and manufacturers to international advocates and a lot of voices, but we really are the only patient group at the table. And our job is to put a face on this really important need that really is a global need. The world needs antibiotics that work. And the CF community just happens to be really at the tip of the spear of that need. So we're excited to be working on Capitol Hill. We're excited to be really working globally, also with a lot of folks in Europe, to try to develop new ways of paying for antibiotics and asking, in our case, particularly the US Congress, to fund ways of developing antibiotics differently. So that's something on the research and development front that we're doing a lot with, and we're excited. So stay tuned for that. We expect that new legislation on this will be introduced really soon. And so it's something very tangible that people can help us with. And my two requests for people who are listening to this great podcast are, if you have a story about how your own personal need for antibiotics or your family's need for antibiotics to share, that is really helpful. As I said, our job in many ways is to put a face on this need and also to keep an eye out for advocacy action alerts. Hopefully everyone is registered to be an advocate at the CF Foundation so that when legislation is introduced, you can call on your members of Congress and your senators to say, this is something I want you to support. And it's exciting because it's bipartisan right now, and there are not that many things that are bipartisan right now in Washington. So it's a nice one to be for. So that's one thing I'm really excited about. And then the other is always, always making sure people with cystic fibrosis have high quality, specialized healthcare. And that means having the insurance that they need to cover that. So there are a whole bunch of things that we're doing both in Washington and in state capitals across the country to really make sure that there's a robust system of health insurance available for people with cystic fibrosis that's affordable for them, whether that be Medicaid or Medicare or private insurance or an insurance plan that they buy through the affordable care marketplace. So there's so many things that we really touch on that. It's always an issue that we address. And excitingly, some of the things that we're working on, particularly this year, is out in state capitals across the country. making sure that some of these insurance programs are adequately funded and asking for states to commit dollars to make sure that people with CF have the healthcare that they need. So there are a lot of campaigns going on out in states where, again, you can raise your voice and making sure that you're signed up to be an advocate at the CF Foundation, cff.org. You can look for advocate and taking action to make sure you're signed up. And that makes sure that you know when there's action to take in your state or at the federal government.
That's wonderful. And I think also you don't even need to be someone with CF or know someone with CF to be an advocate. Definitely what you're saying about just any story or any healthcare issue or story you might know, that impacts so many different groups and so many different communities. And so definitely signing up for the action alerts have been really great for me. It helps me learn more about legislation and policy that's going on. And so if you're kind of a policy nerd and you just want to learn some things about healthcare policy, that's a great place to go. This kind of leads me into my next question of what are some insights you've taken away from your role and how do you feel like advocacy has impacted you personally with just your growth or where you've gone in life?
Oh, that's a good question. An insight I would share is, I sort of alluded to this a minute ago, that no day is ever the same. And the issues that we work on, while there's always a universal linkage to them, that the day-to-day things that we do or month-to-month change pretty rapidly. There are so many ways that we need to raise the voice of the CF community and their needs. So there's always something new on the horizon. And the overarching thing that links them all together is the community and personal stories. And so I think really, to me, what impacts me is the power of story and the power of people. Really, what it all drives home to is, can you connect something that sometimes sounds wonky or academic to how it really impacts somebody's life, how it impacts somebody's hour or day, and really being able to translate that effectively and make it personal is what really drives home and makes successful campaigns or gets you across the finish line with that piece of legislation or that regulation that you want to see. So I think in terms of how advocacy impacts me is I feel good at the end of the day about the stories that people share with me and trust me and my team to be able to carry for them to decision makers, to remind them that this means something to somebody, to a family, to an individual. And again, putting that personal face on something that sometimes seems really distant or far away is powerful and means a lot to me to say, this is what I get to work on.
Again, I'm just hearing the common theme of the power of story and just using your voice and realizing that you're not alone in whatever fight you're going through, and that even if it's healthcare or it might be something else that you're kind of passionate about or that you have going on in your life, there's definitely more than just yourself going through it. And there's definitely a community out there for you to find. And I think that's what I just really appreciate about the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation is that it's so community oriented and that it's not only speaking up about your stories, but truly just listening to the stories of others and kind of working together to say, okay, these are our collective stories and how can we use these to really make a change for our family, our loved ones, and then just people with CF all across the country and the world. It's so exciting just to think about how far-reaching the impact of calling your representative, and if everyone just called the representative or sent an email or had an ongoing relationship with them, how big of an impact that would make long-term.
Hear, hear. Way to go.
Yeah, totally. And so this podcast is kind of geared towards folks who might not already know a lot about advocacy or might know a super lot about advocacy, but might not know how to get started exactly. Or maybe they are already advocates and are just looking for ways they can support ongoing community efforts. So what are some like tangible action items you would say to folks who want to get more involved in advocacy or explore their passions and figure out what they want to advocate for?
I would say start with what you care about, right? Start with something that matters to you. And I have a feeling that probably every one of your listeners, if I asked to name the most important thing to them, they probably would have a hard time. There'd probably be a bunch of different things that they care about. And that's awesome. So what stands out to you that you want to help move and impact? And then start looking around for other people who are interested in the same or other organizations that are doing cool work that speaks to you, that really are aiming for things that you'd like to see happen, be that finding a cure for cystic fibrosis or helping make sure people with CF have their voices heard. Or, you know, for example, something that is also important to me is addressing hunger and making sure that we are closing the gap between people who don't have enough to eat to make sure they do, or helping move towards a better, healthier environment. So who else is thinking about that? Who else is creating solutions that speak to you that you find to be meaningful? And then reach out and get involved. And involvement can take so many different shapes. Certainly, giving money to support the work is always important to organizations across the board. There's so much work to do. So giving them a leg up in terms of a donation, be it $5 or whatever, or asking others to help you support the cause is always meaningful. And like we've talked about a lot in this podcast already, also raising your voice, contributing your voice, and finding out what actions they're looking to take and how you can help. And sometimes that's as simple as sending a text or an email to a decision maker. And sometimes that means sharing your story, like we've talked about and you've done artfully over the years. And sometimes that means going out and doing some work, right? Rolling up your sleeves, be it on a cleanup day or stocking a food pantry or helping set up for a big event. So there's so many different ways. And to me, it's really ultimately about what speaks to you, what speaks to you that you want to see, what change you want to see in the world, who else is doing that work, and how do you get involved? And hopefully you'll find that there are many ways to get involved, and you'll pick the ones that are right for you. And hopefully you'll also pick more than one, because there are so many ways you can make an impact. And it really does make change when we all work on it together.
For sure. And I really appreciate what you said about just finding others who share that passion or a community that's already doing that work, because I think advocacy definitely is a journey of speaking out and sharing your voice and speaking out alongside others, but it's also so much a journey of learning and listening and just hearing what folks who have experience have to say, or folks going through that lived experience want to share with you. And so I think it's definitely kind of like a two-way road. You get to learn a lot from others already doing this work by joining into a community and being less isolated. And then also you get that reward of just really getting to share what your experiences are and how you wish that you could see changes in your life and your loved one's life. So I think that's just so powerful, especially when communities come together to make change. I think we definitely are more powerful together. And I think the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation definitely does a good job of modeling that.
Yeah, I think, who is it? It's Fred Rogers who said, look for the helpers. So to me, it's look for the helpers. Who else is helping to make things better that you care about?
Yeah, that's so good.
And your injured spirit.
Yes, for sure. So just to wrap us up, what are some ways that we can support the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation and the work that you do? I know you've talked a little bit about action alerts. What are some other things people can be doing to really just support this community?
I'm so glad you asked that. The easiest way to help is to get involved. And the easiest way to do that is to go to cff.org. So Cystic Fibrosis Foundation, cff.org. And click right up at the very top on the button. I'm looking at it now. It's right up there on the top right-hand corner called Get Involved. And when you click on that, the world is your oyster. There's so many different ways that you can get involved with us. And I know, Cambria, you have done so many of them over the years, and we thank you for that. It walks you through really a host of options. I'm a little partial personally to the option of advocating. There's a nice button there that will take you to a way to sign up to be an advocate. And you'll hear, once you do that, as you've alluded to already, you'll get a lot of information. You can sign up for webinars, you can send emails, you can help tell your story. There are ways to connect with other people who are also interested. There are ways to help fundraise, so many fun ways. You can volunteer to help on all of these things. You can attend an event. You can donate. So there are so many different ways, and that is really kind of the best way to find your way to help us make a difference in people's lives. And hopefully there's a couple of things there that speak to you if you are interested. We'd love to have you. It's an amazing community.
Yeah, there are events and ways you can get involved all across the country, which I think is just super amazing to see that there are chapters just kind of everywhere. You're like, oh, okay, I didn't know there was a CF chapter here. And I know a few of my listeners are people from TAD, so already know how to get involved, which is so great. And yeah, it's just been so good talking with you and really getting to learn more about policy and advocacy and your journey. And I hope that listeners have a lot to learn and reflect on, especially maybe just go and think about what they're passionate about and ways they can get involved in their communities. So thank you so much for being here.
Oh, thank you so much for having me and for giving us this platform and for everything that you've done over the years. And I know we'll continue to do for CF. And kudos to you for this podcast. Super cool.
Thank you. I appreciate it.